She may be small, but she knows more Nicki Minaj verses than you do. Catherine Carnell! The only thing he loves more than internet memes is Peach Snapple, Colin Seguero! Not only is he a competitive swimmer, but he can throw cards. Nathan Zerflew! He has a snake at home that he wants you to come see, and I'm not being suggestive. Avery Fischera! She has an undying love of toes. Annika Throne! As a matter of fact, this man is certified in CPR. Sean Johnson! She has the same haircut as me, but I can assure you her personality is 10 times better. Sophie Greenway. The only thing he loves more than a good book is a good Haitian folk song. Luke Seguero. She likes long walks on the beach and Dungeons and Dragons. Casey Walsh. He's handsome, he's charismatic, and he's forever confused by flightless birds, Jacob Biermeier! And finally,
There's two more!
Almost finally, chicks dig him because he surfs, Max Walter! And finally, he wears sunglasses because his future is brighter than mine. Reese Hendricks!
We're having some technical difficulties, as you can see.
All right. I'm going to remind the audience, we asked for a lot of suggestions, so we're going to have to keep it PG to PG-13. No R-rated here. We didn't have you sign a waiver, so we can't do that. But thank you all for coming out. Let's get started with the games. Alright, so, for this first game, I'm gonna need a place you wouldn't want to make friends.
Detroit.
Whoa!
Bathroom!
Funeral?
Bathroom.
Alright, bathrooms. That works. Second off, I'm gonna need an object that you would bring to show and tell in your elementary school classroom.
A puppy.
A rubber duck. Awesome. So, my lovely improv-ers are going to craft you a scene involving a puppy and a bathroom. And they're gonna have 1 minute to do this. Once that minute runs out, we're gonna have them do the same scene in 30 seconds, and then 10 seconds. And then we're just gonna get crazy with it. Are you ready, improvers? All right, they're ready. Ready, set, begin.
What are you doing in the guy's bathroom? That's a little weird.
This is the men's restroom?
Yeah, there's a clear sign up right there that says man's bathroom.
Oh, I'm so excited. They have this free little men's.
Was it because I was washing my dog over here? Like, or something?
What?
It's cute. I know it's cute.
That's my dog! That
is not
my
dog. Yes, that is not her dog. That is my dog.
You stole it from me.
I did not steal that dog from you. That is my dog.
I'm holding that leash. I'm not involved in this. I'm holding the leash.
Okay, and that's just a leash. Let's get that out. Hey, little puppers. Hey, little Xerxes. It's okay, little dude. Please stay away from my dog. Please stay away from my dog. Here, you want a free dog?
All right, there you have it, folks. 1 minute. Now, I want an honest opinion. You think they can do that in 30 seconds? I certainly do. Ready, set, begin.
What are you doing in the guy's bathroom?
This is men's bathroom?
There is a clear sign.
Oh, we're enjoying the men's.
Is it because I have a dog?
The dog? Oh,
my cute little dog?
You stole my dog!
I did not steal your dog.
Yes, you did.
I did not. Xerxes has a little moon. Oh, he's so cute.
Oh,
he's definitely
not.
You want
30 seconds. I definitely do. Ready, set, begin.
Oh, why are you?
This is not the kids' restroom.
I mean, just look at this little cute little dog.
That's my dog. That
is not my dog. It's not my dog.
10 seconds. All right, we're gonna mix it up a little bit. What say we do it backwards in 10 seconds? Think you can do it? All right,
here.
Ready, set, go.
Dog.
Oh, thank you. Oh, he's little Xerxes. He's so cute. Oh, that's not your dog. That is straight up my dog. That is definitely not your dog. I mean,
10 seconds.
Get this leash out.
That's my dog.
Wait.
All right,
guys.
10 seconds, Jacob. We're gonna try it all in forward, but in 1 second. Are you ready? Begin!
Take a dog!
There you have it, folks. Alright, we're gonna do one more round of quickest minute, is what we call that game. So, I'm gonna need a place you don't wanna bring your baby. Sounds good to me. All right, how about something you don't want to have for dinner tonight? You do not want it.
Meatloaf.
Meatloaf? Did I hear meatloaf? All right, that's it then. We're doing a scene with meatloaf in a jam. Contestants, are you ready? They're probably ready. All right, 1 minute, ready? Set, go!
Alright, we gotta find a way out of this jail cell ASAP.
These bars are so thick.
It's okay. You look around the room. Maybe there's something under the bed or something.
Deliver it!
Over here.
Meatloaf.
Yeah, our meatloaf. Right, thank you.
Enjoy that. Use it wisely. Actually, I might help with.
Sure.
Don't you have a job?
Well,
hey, what are you prisoners doing?
A nail file.
I'm
just
a delivery man.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Go. You want to be arrested? Yeah?
Yeah.
Hey! Where are you going?
The alarms! No!
Alright, 1 minute. Seconds. Sound good? Sounds great. Thanks, guys. All right, 30 seconds. Ready, set, begin. So two people are doing all the dialogue, but they can't move. And we have two other people whose main objective is to move these first two people. They do every leg, every arm, everything. All right, so I'm gonna need a place you don't wanna be on a Saturday night.
Laundromat.
Thanks, Alan. Let's do a laundromat. Contestants, are you ready to perform a scene in a laundromat? Sean's got it. All right, let's do it.
No, that's my dryer.
I'd really like to be looking at that dryer.
Me too.
My clothes are in that dryer.
No, those are my clothes.
No. Unless you like women's clothing. Yeah, that's not mine. I'd really like to be looking at it, though.
Me too. Wait, that isn't my clothes.
I told you.
I'm so sorry.
You should be.
I wish I could look at you and make this a heartfelt moment.
You know my secret now.
Oh boy, I'm gonna start doing that.
You got me.
Wow, that's a nice floor.
I really enjoyed looking at it.
That's a nice wall, too.
Wow, I wish I could see
it. Oh, you see that? Oh. See that painting?
Wow.
What a nice painting.
I want to see it.
I think I know that guy.
Can we steal it?
That's illegal.
Your point?
I'm just captivated with its beauty.
Wow, me too, except I'm not facing it anymore.
You know, that is a beautiful painting. Nice seeing you guys. Alright, our next game is called the dating game. You've all seen a dating show, right? Or heard of one? I've never actually seen one in real life. But, so we have some contestants. They're going to come out here and ask you questions about who they are themselves. Contestants? Come on out.
Oh. Okay. So, an annoying habit that you picked up over the years. Come on, not everyone at once. Biting your fingernails, okay.
Okay, we're gonna stick with the annoying theme. I need an annoying celebrity. That's fair. Okay. Give me your favorite Disney villain.
All right, next we're gonna need a contestant from the audience. Do I have any volunteers? All right, AJ. Get up here, AJ. All right, so I'm gonna give AJ some questions to ask these lovely folks. But not before I do an introduction. Hey everyone, welcome to Estes Park High School's dating game. Here we have very eligible bachelor, AJ Saucier. AJ, tell us a little about yourself.
I like cards.
He likes cards. One at a time, ladies, please. All right, I'm gonna give AJ some questions to ask our lovely contestants. Excuse me, how do you have fun? Contestant number one.
You're implying I have fun? I have lots of fun.
Contestant number two.
Well, I really, really like to make music. You know, I was on that kids show ages ago, but we haven't talked about that because nobody knows that was me. But yeah, music is fun, and you know, I love fashion, anything, you know, that I'm not really wearing because, you know, clothes.
Contestant three.
I like to spend my time at the shelters. Puppies are my favorite.
AJ, do you like puppies?
I like puppies.
How many of them would you like to have?
52.
That doesn't cut it.
So, what have you always wanted to do but haven't yet?
Contestant number two, what's going to do this time?
I'd really like to have a music career.
Okay. Contestant number one, thoughts?
I mean, I bite someone else's fingernail.
And contestant number three.
I'd always like to have an endless amount of dogs.
Okay. How do you feel about dogs? Because if you don't take her, I'm going to. All right. We got a few more questions.
Contestant number one, what are you looking for in a man?
Fingernails.
AJ has fingernails, I would point out. AJ, show everyone your fingernails.
Very nice. Very nice. Contestant number two, what are you looking for in a man?
Liam Hemsworth.
Celebrity gossip, am I right? And contestant number three, what are you looking for in a man?
Money to buy me more fur coats.
Okay. Got one more question for you to ask, man. What is your idea of a perfect first date? Contestant number three.
On the perfect first date, you would take me to the shelter and get me as many dogs as I want. And then you would take me to my sewing room. And those dogs would come in very handy.
Wait, is that what happens in that movie? Okay, let's move it on. Contestant number two, same question.
Well, I think we could go and destroy a building, you know, with a wrecking ball. I think that could
be adventurous.
Do you like an adventurous lady? There you have it, folks. He likes adventurous ladies. And contestant number one, what is your idea of a perfect first date?
I mean, I'm adventurous too. There's this French restaurant. They specialize in fingernails.
Yeah. AJ's always talking to me about how he wants to try more exotic food. All right, we're gonna wrap it up here. Contestant three, why are you the eligible bachelorette for AJ?
I am the eligible bachelorette, because if you don't choose me, I will take your dog.
AJ, do you have any dogs?
Yeah, a little bit.
Bribery doesn't work. Contestant number two?
Well, obviously I'm very good looking, I wouldn't be famous, and I'm a musician, which everybody loves, and I'm rich, did I mention I'm rich?
She's rich. Contestant number three.
Maybe we can fingernail later.
Finger and nail, I would point out. All right, AJ, you've had some time to mull it over. Who is your pick?
Well, I don't want to lose my dog, but...
Money.
But fingernails, AJ.
No.
I'll take them. Testing number two. Woo!
Alright, thank you so much, you guys. We actually have the world's greatest speller with us here today. Please welcome them out. Now, sir, I know you're the world's greatest speller, but I am very forgetful. Would you mind telling me what your name is?
My
name
is
Steven.
Steven!
Steven Steven, folks! Round of applause for Steven Steven!
Yeah!
Alright, I'm gonna need a little bit more audience involvement here. Give me some words. They don't have to be real. They shouldn't be real. As wacky and miscellaneous as you can come up with. Do I have any suggestions?
Snuffleupagus.
Snuffleupagus. Alright. Steve, would you mind spelling Snuffleupagus for me?
Snuffleupagus. S. N.
U.
F.
F.
L.
E.
U.
F.
O.
G.
U.
N.
S.
Snuffleupagus.
You know, that was exactly right. Would you mind using it? Would you mind defining it, actually?
Snuffleupagus. A
Snuffleupagus
is
a
type
of
cheese
that
smells
very
beautiful.
Snuffleupagus.
Smells beautiful. Would you mind using it in a sentence for me, Steve?
Snuffleupagus. Grandma
ate
Snuffleupagus.
There you have it, folks. Keep it wacky. Steve?
Stiflecake.
S-T-I-F-L-E.
C-A.
K-E.
Stiflecake.
Would you mind defining Stiflecake for me?
Stiflecake.
Stiflecake
is
when
you
eat
too
much
apples
and
get
really
gassy.
Stiflecake.
Actually, Stiflecake last week. Would you mind using it in a sentence for me, Stacy?
Stiflecake.
Grandma
stiflecaked
all
last
night.
Stiflecaked.
That was exactly right, Steve. I think some more words. Would you repeat that? All right, cool. Mufaka. All right. Mufaka.
Mufaka.
M.
E.
O.
F.
Mufaka.
Maybe that's ancient Gaelic spelling? I don't know. I'm not up on my language.
Yes.
It is. Congratulations.
Thank you. Would you mind defining that word for me?
Mufaka.
Mufaka
can
be
used
for
cleaning
your
eyeball.
Mufaka.
How about you use that in a sentence for me, Steve?
Mufaka.
I
went
to
the
store
and
found
a
Mufaka
to
use
on
my
mother.
Mufaka.
Alright. Shut it up.
Rolling.
Could you repeat that?
Zolnik.
Steve, would you spell Zolnik for me?
Zolnik.
C.
H.
E.
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 E. S.
E.
Zolnik.
And now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think I heard that in the last Harry Potter movie. Would you mind defining it as it's used in Harry Potter?
Zolnik.
Voldemort.
Zolnik.
He sure does, guys. He sure does. Okay. Can I have one final word?
Discombobulated.
I think that's a word. Is it not?
Harder.
Long.
Oh.
One at a time, please.
Polio encephalomalacia.
Would you mind spelling polio encephalomalacia for me, Steve?
Polio encephalomalacia. P
O
L
I
O
S
P
H
E
M
O
L
A
S
I
A.
Polio.
Now, I'm a very well-versed man. I'm very pious, and I know a biblical word when I see one. And polio encephalomalacia is certainly a biblical word. Would you mind giving me the verse from which polio encephalomalacia was from?
Polio encephalomalacia. Genesis?
1:1. And
God
gave them polio
encephalomalacia.
Polio encephalomalacia. Polio encephalomalacia
is
a
bird
that
flies
under
clouds
and
eat
your
face.
Act out a scene, and two other actors are going to be on the sideline pretending to be deaf. They're not going to hear a thing that the first two actors do. Now, when I call time, the other two actors will come on the stage and, to the best of their knowledge, reenact the first two actors' scene. Can I get my actors out here? Deaf replay? Alright. Got our deaf individuals right there. Alright. Give me a place you wouldn't expect to see your doctor at.
Strip club.
We're not gonna do that one. Sorry?
Monster truck rally.
Monster truck rally, yeah! Nice, dude. All right, you guys are gonna give us a scene at a monster truck rally. Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Do it.
Room.
Room. Oh my gosh, you're my hero.
Hey, kid.
Bob Jones, I heard that this year you're gonna pull out all the big shots and your monster truck can actually fly? Is that true?
Oh, you know, do you want to see it fly?
I would love to. Could I maybe sit in it while you fly it?
You can sit in the back.
Great.
And make sure to wear a seatbelt.
There are no seatbelts back here.
Hang on. Okay. All right. You ready?
Sure.
Okay. Let's go. Bruce.
Whoa!
Deaf individuals, do you think you know what happened? I think you do. Are you ready to show me?
Yeah.
All right, go.
Hey. Oh man, are you Luke Skywalker?
Yeah.
I love you. I mean, would you mind if I take a ride on your show?
Yeah, just get off. Tell you all about my journey as a fellow Jedi.
Oh, wow.
So,
I've heard so many amazing stories
about
you.
Got my arm cut off and I beat Darth Vader. So that was pretty spectacular.
Well,
anyway, you want to get on?
I would love to.
Sir. Yeah, alright, okay.
Just back here?
Yep, back there is perfect.
Don't you have any seatbelts? Okay, are you sure about this?
Yeah, are you ready?
Sure, yeah.
Alright.
Whoa! Whoa! Oh! I can't hold on! I'm gonna fall out! Ah!
Oh! Dude! Oh! Hold on to me like the pole that I held on to right after he cut my arm off.
Well, thank you, sir. I can't believe it. I almost just floated off in space there.
I just saved lives.
No,
that's all it does, folks. Worst. It's pretty self-explanatory. Can I get my contestants out here? Alright.
Are we the worst, Seth?
You are the worst, Nathan.
Some would say the world.
I wouldn't, Max. They're worse. Alright, so you're gonna give me a topic, and these wonderful, awful young men are going to show you the world's worst in whatever you suggest. So, can I get a very high-paying profession?
Doctor.
Doctor? All right.
Doctor, you guys ready to show me the world's worst doctor?
Betcha.
Alright, go to it.
Is that supposed to be in there?
Oh god, I dropped my watch in there.
Hey, watch what I can do with the kidney and the heart.
Right, there we go, he's all patched up. Have you seen my wedding ring?
Well, technically it's a PhD in political science, but I'll take a look.
Oh no, don't worry, don't be nervous about the surgery. It's completely non-invasive. In fact, the anesthesia will kill you first.
Hey, let's switch these two.
Now, tell me, did you feel... That wasn't supposed to happen.
Why'd you use the scissors?
Now, I'm gonna diagnose you in total, normal, everyday conversation. How was your day today?
Pretty good, not bad.
That's strange because you have leukemia.
All right, can I get a really low-paying profession?
Teacher.
I was advised against teacher because we actually have some in the house. Yeah. Teachers, everyone.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, another low-paying profession.
McDonald's.
I don't think that's a profession. Maybe a McDonald's.
Fry cook.
McDonald's fry cook. You guys ready to show me the world's worst McDonald's fry cook?
McChicken, more like McSpitting.
I just gotta chop up these. I think it's gonna be alright.
I mean, this is the allowed amount of bug parts that the FDA, so.
the chef has just a bit of a cough, so it's fine. You just ignore the cricket stuff.
Some extra salt will cover this up.
What do you mean you got more mice? Everything looks like chicken when it's breaded.
I got one more.
And why I complain about my food? Give him something to complain about.
Alright, I'm having so much fun with this. Let's get a job where you have to use your hands and remember that it's PG-13. Proctologist?
No!
We'll go with jeweler for now.
Hey, I just gotta hammer out this metal. My fingernail. It will look good on the piece. Just glue it on.
Oh. You wanted 15 carat? I already went to the supermarket, though.
Oh, you wanted a piercing. I thought you asked for gauges.
Oh, do you want real diamonds? I was just gonna run to the Vibe and Diamond and grab some of those little glass thingies.
All right, not a lot of material. No worries. How about a very dangerous job?
Proctologist.
Zookeeper. Any more ideas?
A logger.
A logger.
Teacher.
What? I'm gonna go with zookeeper.
Oh, don't worry about it. This glass is practically bulletproof. Watch.
Your kid fell in? Well, here's is an animal, after all.
No, ma'am. I swear the fences are regulation height. They're about 20, all right? The mountain lions can only jump about 22. You should be all right.
Hold my beard, watch this.
Watch out! They like to fling it! Oh, God.
Sure you can ride it, just wear a helmet. No, I promise you, I've done this before. Watch.
And this finger I lost to the geese. Nasty little buggers they are. Cincinnati 1 to Cincinnati 2.
Yeah, we gotta put down the gorilla.
Alright, we'll wrap up the occupations. What is one job that you would never, ever want to have? Never. You know, I love my teachers. Extra credit? Another job? Never want to have.
Plumber.
I like plumber. Show me the world's worst plumber.
Yeah, no, I'm telling you, I'm pretty sure I did this right, but I hooked up the toilet tube away from the sink tube. They shouldn't be connected.
Why does it cost so much less? I use my gum instead of putty. You love it.
Yeah, your pipes are destroyed, lady. That's not a euphemism.
Give me a famous superhero.
Iron Man.
Iron Man. I like Iron Man. Alright, show me the world's worst scene from Iron Man.
Yeah, pretty sure I bolted these, right?
You can't hurt me. Oh god, he's got water.
I am Aluminum Man! Oh god!
Let's throw a Hello Kitty paint job on.
Alright, there you have it, folks. The world's worst at Anthony's Peak. Shut it up. Late for work. We have a show called Party Hoes. All right, can I get my contestants out here? All right, so we have our party host right here. He's gonna go out in the hall for a little bit. And these lovely people are gonna ask you what characters or people or jobs or really anything that they should be.
Give me a fairy tale character.
Cinderella. What is your least favorite anime?
Casey, who are you going with?
Scott. We're gonna go with Scott.
Something embarrassing that's happened in your childhood.
In your pants.
Ooh,
okay. Alright, so we have Cinderella, we have a skunk. We have a man with pee in his pants. Whether it is his or not remains to be seen. Nathan, you have a party to host.
Crap, I do. It's my dog's birthday. I host a party. Oh, man.
Ding dong.
Oh, hey.
Hi.
Ding dong!
What's that?
I have to say you have a really loud doorbell and I might spray when I get excited.
Awesome! There's food and drink over there.
Ding dong!
So the home.
Okay.
Hello!
That's great too.
Come on, come on in!
This is like my second party.
Bathroom!
It's stressing me out!
It's late for work.
It's fine, it's improv. It's okay.
All right, so, one of these lovely people is gonna be late for his job. Is it Colin?
Yes.
It's Colin. I'm gonna need him to leave first.
Awesome. All
right, I'm gonna need a reason for him being late to work.
Spill coffee.
Spill coffee. Sounds good to me. How about a reason to get out of a speeding ticket?
I'm giving birth.
He's giving birth. All right, finally, someone you wouldn't want to run into on your way to work. How about that?
King Kong.
King Kong. I like it. So, spilled his coffee. Had a baby, and ran into King Kong. How was your morning? You guys ready? All right, his boss is gonna let him in now.
Yeah,
he's pretty angry.
He's like, scaring me, come fire! 5 hours, really? Think you can pull that stunt on me?
I'm so sorry, I promise you, I'm perfectly reasonable, probably totally normal, nothing weird about explanation.
Because of all your reasons, they're always reasonable.
Of course. So, not to believe this. I got out of bed and I was drinking. And I spilled it all over
in the morning?
And it spilled all over my shirt.
Lord Johnson.
Yeah, I know, it was weird. I just kept
drinking.
It was hot and It burned me. I spilled it on myself. Yes, I was drinking coffee.
You're heating. Oh, there you are. Alright. Yeah, I just thought you were a drunkard. So. But there's gotta be more. You're 5 hours late.
My wife. She was going into labor.
Your wife?
Suggestions as to what theme they should sing about and tell you how they're going to be singing it. Can I have my actors out here?
There you are.
Dope.
Oh, man.
Sup, everyone. My name's Nathan. I'm going to be singing Miley Cyrus songs. Variations of them, of course. But I'm going to need a item you would find in your kitchen.
Spatula.
Rolling pin.
Rolling pin? Made a mixer?
Microwave.
Microwave. I like microwave. All right, cool.
I'm Catherine. I'm going to be singing female pop songs about, let's see, I need you guys to give me something like your worst memory about school. That's great. No, your least favorite thing about school. Like, what was the least favorite thing about school for you guys?
Math class.
Anything else? I like math class. Put it on math class.
Hey guys, I'm Annika, and I'll be singing Broadway songs, obviously. So I'm going to be meeting the craziest teacher in this school. Funniest, craziest teacher. Toffney.
Hello, my name is Max. I will be singing classic rock songs, because why not? But first, I need a very popular movie series. Shout out.
X-Files.
Lord of the Rings? I heard Lord of the Rings. I think you will.
All right. There's our actors and what kind of music they're going to be singing and the genre. So, I'm going to be shuffling my iPod Shuffle. Because I still have an iPod Shuffle while I'm walking to work. All right, putting in my earbuds, and I'm pressing play.
Just a small town hobbit living in a grassy hole.
Shuffle.
So it's gonna be a frozen dinner. I'm always gonna have to heat it up real good.
Shuffle.
Cause baby, now I've got physics, and I don't think I can solve this. Toffney, what the heck are you doing? I don't understand this!
Shuffle!
I am leaving my students on a trip to Sweden, but it's all okay, because how they learns from videos anyway.
Reverse!
And I'll set fire to this pain.
Shuffle.
Oh, walking way too long. Oh, not even halfway there yet.
Shuffle.
I came in like a microwave. If I put a spoon in there, I would misbehave.
Shuffle. Very good.
These axes and omegas. Who decided to put ladders in math?
Shuffle.
There's something happening here. What it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a ring over there telling me I have to walk to a volcano or something. I don't even understand anymore.
Verse.
It's the hard knock life for my students. It's the hard knock life for my students. While they are stuck learning, I am loving Taylor Swift.
Throw Gandalf in the hole. Don't worry, he comes back in the second one.
Spoiler! Shuffle.
And we can't burn your frozen souffle, but we'll still try if you put it on high.
All right. Now I've got to work now. I feel very musically educated. All right, thanks so much, you guys. All right, thank you.